Short bowel syndrome with intestinal failure is a rare condition. The principal causes of short bowel syndrome with intestinal failure are IBD, for example, Crohn's disease. You should do some resection on small bowel due to inflammatory processes. You have also vascular disease, for example, mesenteric infarction due to a thrombosis on arterial or venous thrombosis. And you have other causes, such as abdominal traumatism, or also post-radiation enteritis due to past cancer. The impact of short bowel syndrome with intestinal failure in terms of quality of life is very important because you will have some social complication. You can imagine when you have home parenteral nutrition during 12 hours per day, it's very complicated to travel, to be with parents, family, but also to go to work, because the technique is very important in the day of the patient. We can see in our current practice that you have some patients with time can decrease parenteral support. The decrease of parenteral support with any drug is due to spontaneous intestinal adaptation. So you have an increase of energy absorption during the time. You have also an increase of eating in this patient, and it's possible to decrease and sometimes to wean off the patient. That's the intestinal adaptation. I believe that we have different unmet needs for short bowel syndrome with intestinal failure. We need to improve the knowledge on medical schools. We need to improve the awareness of the disease. And the other aspect, we need to do more research because we need to improve the knowledge about, for example, intestinal adaptation, how we can increase intestinal adaptation. I believe that all patients with short bowel syndrome and intestinal failure should have an equal access to the best medical care.